Reptile Explorers. So I just want to do this video, just a short quick video of today's event. So went to Tricross Zoo, and I just want to basically mention that if anyone's going to go to Tricross Zoo, it's really not worth it, to be honest. It's overrated, it's overpriced, there's not many animals there, and the animals that are there you can't really get a chance to see. You have no chance of interacting with anything, and you know, to be honest, it's not worth it. It really ain't worth it. So, you know, I can't wait to go to Chester Zoo. Now, Chester Zoo's up north, obviously, in Chester, and it's supposed to be amazing. It's supposed to take at least up to maybe two days to walk around the whole thing, which sounds awesome to me. They've got snakes, they've got reptiles, they've got all sorts, right? And that's how a fine zoo should be, where Tricross had virtually nothing, silch. And it was just like, you walk around, you've paid almost 70 something quid, 2 hours, you finished the whole zoo. And then by the time, let's say you bought a coffee, maybe a sandwich, whatever, 100 quid, that's 100 quid, just in 2 hours, for something that you didn't even get a chance to enjoy properly, really, because there's no way of actually interacting with much. So I know my YouTube, I know the video I just posted, you know, I said it's like, it's all right, you know, it's kind of all right, but I was walking around at the time. Until I got home, I was like, maybe it weren't the best. So anyway, like I said, this channel is going to be a bit of a mixture of, like, you know, going to zoos, checking out some animals. I know that video, the post I've just put up isn't the best for actually seeing any animals because there weren't really many around. Hopefully next time I'm actually going to talk to some zookeepers, try and get some more professional information from, like, zoologists and so on, and, you know, some proper keepers and what have you. Also some good news, so hopefully, fingers crossed, January time I should be getting a boa, either a baby boa or a fully grown female boa. So fingers crossed for that. And then February, March or April time, one of the three, I should be turning my spare room into a snake room, so should be able to get a little bit of a tour of that. I should have a bit more of a bigger collection as well, so, you know, we'll be able to discuss a bit more, we can even learn together, you know, because I'm trying to get hold of some reptiles I've never had before, or, you know, you don't have chance to really see much because of, you know, they're not really that much of a variety. So I'm looking to get some, like, crocodile skinks, false water cobra and so on, just so I can learn a bit about them as well, so I can, you know, study the snakes, you know, study the behavior, feeding pattern, the shedding pattern, you know, the general, like, you know, the personality of the snakes and the lizards and so on, you know, keeping an eye on the client, so what I meant to say here is the temperatures and the humidity, and keep an eye on, like, the general health of the environment of the snake. Just had a full day of just cold weather, kind of interesting day. I'm tired, so I just want to say, if you like my video, please give it a thumbs up, please subscribe, hit that notification bell. I will be posting more regularly, and just remember, stay strong, reptile lovers, and just keep going at it.